Good morning, everyone.
My name is Zai, and before my presentation starts, I want to play a game.
Hi, I'm Zai from Taiwan. Today's video is a remake of my final English presentation from when I was studying abroad at RCIS in Toronto. Due to the nerves and limited equipment at the time, I decided to recreate the entire presentation in this video format. If you're interested in watching the original live presentation, you can join my membership channel, where I'm handed it for members only. Let's get started! Today, before my presentation begins, I wanna play a quick game with you guys. Here is a lollipop made with 100% pure maple syrup. Sounds good, huh? Who wants it? And here are 3 cups. What I'm going to do is put the lollipop into one of these cups, and then I'll ask you to guess where it is. If you guess it right, you get the lollipop. In this segment, I hit the lollipop into one of these cups labeled A, B, and C, and ask each of my classmates, including the teacher Corey, to guess where the lollipop was. After they made their guesses, I revealed one of the cups that didn't contain the lollipop, and this is where the important decision comes in. At this point, they had to choose whether to stay with their original cup or switch to the other. This choice is crucial. I also invite you, the audience, to think about it. If it were you, after I revealed the empty cup, would you stay with your original choice or switch to the other cup? Here are some clips of us playing the game.
Which one?
B.
B? Okay, then I'll tell you C is empty. Will stay or change?
Change
to A? Mm. Okay, you get lollipops. Okay, A, B, C.
C.
C? Okay, then I'll tell you B is empty. Change or stay?
Change
to A? Okay, good. Which lollipop is A, B, C? Choose one. A. Okay, I'll tell you C is empty. Stay A or switch?
A.
A? Still A?
Yes.
Okay, it's empty. Okay, now.
Yes. I recorded with the ratio of those who chose to switch and those who stayed with their original choice. At the end of the game, we found that people who switched had an 87.5% chance of winning the lollipop, while those who stayed had only a 20% chance. Crazy, huh? Now, let's continue with the explanation. Here's what just happened. I'm going to introduce a famous math problem called the Monty Hall problem. This problem is named after Monty Hall, who was the host of an old TV show called Let's Make a Deal. It's similar to the game we played, but the real situation is, there are 3 closed doors in front of an audience. Behind one door, there's a brand new car, which is the biggest prize. And behind the other 2 doors, there are goats, which means nothing happens. Monty Hall, the host, will ask the audience to choose a door. Then, he'll always open one of the other 2 doors that the audience didn't pick. And the door always shows a goat. Now, here's the highlight. The biggest question. Monty Hall will ask the audience, do you want to stay with your original choice or switch to the unopened door? Now, we may see some people stay their choice, thinking it doesn't matter if they switch or stay, or that the probability are the same, right? But math tells us it's not true. If you really want to win the car, you should always choose to switch. And this will double your chances from 33% to 66% to win the car.
Nani?
Because of the time limit, I'll give 2 explanations for you. And there are many other explanations on YouTube. So if mine doesn't make sense to you, feel free to check those out. Here's the first one. Let's say there are 52 poker cards here. And I ask you to guess which card is the ace of hearts. Pick one. Then I'll reveal the other cards one by one, showing that none of them is the ace of hearts, until the only one card remains in my hand. Now, let me ask again. Do you want to switch to this card, or stay with your original choice? You might win the lollipop, bro. At this point, you might think, oh, teacher Zain, I'm the chosen one. I can pick the ace of hearts with a chance of 1 in 52. Fine, I accept that. But what if there were 10,000 doors that I want you to choose from? You can win the car by only picking the right door. But after you choose, I'll open the rest of 9,998 doors to show how much I love goats and keeping them. Would you switch to the last unopened door? So far, does this make sense to anyone now? If still not, that's okay. The first time I heard about this problem when I was a child, I was thinking, what the heck? What is he talking about? and it took me a while to accept this truth. I even wrote a C++ program into a computer and ran it a million times. And the results showed that switching doors wins nearly 66% compared to staying wins only 33%. Now, there's another explanation. I hope this one makes it clearer. Let's say there are 3 doors. The probability of you winning the car is 1 in 3. We all agree this number, right? If you don't, you might need to go back to elementary school and study basic math. Actually, I wanted to say that in the presentation, but no one disagreed with it. 残念. This is the situation if you always choose to stay, no matter what the host does. Now, let's imagine if you always choose to switch. There are 3 situations that could happen. First, if you pick the door with goal A, the host will always open the door to show you goal B. And since you always choose to switch, you will win the car. Second, if you pick the door with goal B, the host will always open the door with goal A. And again, since you always choose to switch, you'll win the car. Third, if you accidentally pick the door with the car, the host will show you either goal A or goal B. And because you always switch, you'll lose in this case. But remember, you always choose to switch, right? So let's see. If you want to win a car eventually, what should you do at the first step? You need to pick the door with the goal at the beginning. Then you'll eventually win the car because you always switch, right? And what is the probability of picking a door with the goal at the beginning? It's 2/3 or 66%. Got it? By the way, there is another cool situation that I didn't have time to mention in the presentation. If Corey picks door A and I open door C, then Emily comes in. She doesn't know what just happened and is simply asked to guess between door A and door B. So, what is the probability for her to pick the right door, you think? It's 50-50. Amazing, huh? So, the Monty Hall problem is a great example of how our instincts about probabilities can be wrong. There are many ways even using complicated mathematical explanations, but you'll always find that math shows switching gives a better chance of winning car. The Monty Hall problem teaches us to think carefully about probability and not always trust our instincts. Thank you for listening. I hope you guys found that math can be amazing and interesting. Applause.
So who hasn't lollipop?
I want.
One take.
You got one shot.
Sigh. Whoa. Wow. A memorable presentation. Very fun. The skill, wow. So it was like interactive, it was fun. You used the board, you kind of like.